Well, good morning. It's the middle of the week. It's Wednesday. And Matthew says the following. Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees! You are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous. Inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evil doing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees! You are hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets, adorn the memorials of the righteous, and say, 'If we had lived in the time of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood.' Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are the children of murder, those who murdered the prophets. Now fill up what your ancestors measured out." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. This builds upon Monday's gospel and yesterday's, which was really horrific in the execution of John the Baptist. Jesus is warning them, don't be quite so righteous. Don't say that, oh, well, if we were there, we would have been much better. You may well have joined the mob. You may well have joined those that shed the blood of the prophets. Who do you think you are? Now you can stand up and say you're righteous. Why? Because of the passage of time, or you want to stand out from the crowd and think, make other people think you're better than you are? No. Jesus really paints that picture like he did on Monday. You are like whitewashed tombs. You are very nice on the outside, but inside you're filled with dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Boy, oh boy, is that ever a warning? My God, none of us wants to be painted as that in our lives. And yet some people are, like the story we heard yesterday, like people all around the world who today will commit horrible crimes. Like people around the world today who will be at war with one another. When does it end? It still goes on, right? There are so many people who on the outside appear to be very, very righteous and, you know, everything seems to be fine, but on the inside, filled with anger and hatred and all those really terrible things. This has kind of been the message for the last few days, and it's a warning in a way. It's kind of not one of those upbeat parables that Jesus talks about calling people to discipleship. These gospels are warnings about the road that every one of us is capable of going down if we are not careful, if we do not pray a little bit every day, be in touch with our heart every day, explore the goodness that is within every single day, and bring it out so that we may be seen as true disciples of Christ, who bring love of God and love of neighbor to fruition. I talked about at the end of the gospel, talked about that at the end of yesterday's gospel, and I leave you with that today. This is a mere image of Monday and a warning about what we heard about yesterday. Live righteously, my friends. Practice what you preach. If you talk the talk, as I said, walk the walk. Take care. I'll see you Thursday.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. You recall, brothers and sisters, our toil and drudgery. Working night and day in order not to burden any of you, we proclaim to you the gospel of God. You are witness, and so is God, how devoutly and justly and blamelessly we behave toward you believers. As you know, we treated each one of you as a father treats his children, exhorting and encouraging you and insisting that you walk in a manner worthy of God, who calls you into his kingdom and glory. And for this reason, we too give thanks to God unceasingly, that in receiving the word of God from hearing us, you received it not as the word of men, but as it truly is, the word of God, which is now at work in you who believe. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The responsorial psalm is, "You have searched me and you know me, Lord. You have searched me and you know me, Lord. From where can I go? Where can I go from your spirit? From your presence, where can I flee? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I sing to the netherworld, you are present there. You have searched me, and you know me, Lord. If I take the wings of the dawn, if I settle at the furthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall guide me, and your right hand hold me fast. You have searched me, and you know me, Lord. If I say, surely the darkness shall hide me, the night shall be my light. For you, darkness itself, is not dark. The night shines as the day. You have searched me, Lord, and you know me.
Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God as Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And good morning. And to you watching out there in television land, we welcome you as well, and we are very happy to have you as part of our congregation worshiping this morning. We place ourselves in the presence of our God. Father in heaven, Jesus proclaims in the gospel that the church is built upon rock, and that is Peter. Church is also built upon our shoulders. May we shoulder it well in the way we love one another. Lord, have mercy. May we raise others up who have been away from our church, lost in faith. Christ, have mercy. May we be a living example of faith alive in the world. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command, to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash, and give over to him your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot, to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship you at your holy temple.
Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
I will give thanks to your name because of your kindness and your truth. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me.
Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
The Lord is exalted, yet the lowly he sees, and the proud he knows from afar. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands.
Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God! How inscrutable are his judgments, and how unsearchable his ways! For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor, or who has given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked his disciples this question: Who do people say that the Son of Man is? They replied, Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. He said to them, But who do you say that I am? Simon Peter said in reply, You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus said to him in reply, Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, Peter, upon you I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Then he strictly ordered the disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord. Last week before Mass, I shared some thoughts with you about the future of the parish, the church, and a number of other things. And I want to continue on that thread. Today, having finished the book, share a couple more thoughts. And I was debating which way to take it, but when I read the gospel, it became crystal clear. Because in the gospel, he says very, very firmly, You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld will not prevail against it. The church is the people of God. It's you, all of you, and me. And everyone worshiping in a church this morning, everywhere they are. The church is people. The building is nice, but the church essentially are the people of God. That is simple theology, not high-minded, not easy, not difficult to grab hold of. You are all the church. Think about that. No matter what you saw when the mirror looked back at you this morning and you might have thought, I could look better today if I walk out of the house, God could care less. You are the church, and upon your shoulders, the church rests. This parish rests, and so do all other churches all around the world, and synagogues too, and holy places, wherever they are. He lets them know that the gates of the netherworld will not prevail against it, but that's not really what we need to worry about. The netherworld is not knocking at the door, but there are other sociological forces and difficulties that we do need to worry about, that we do have to be concerned about. When I first came to this parish and walked in, I knew that I did not have all the necessary skills to be the pastor. I looked around and I thought there have to be kinds of like seminars and places to go, people to listen to learn. And one of the ones I found was the Pastoral Leadership Conference in Phoenix, Arizona. And I flew there and I stayed for several days and learned a lot from some very, very bright people about aspects of pastoral leadership. And I brought that home. And then I was at a convention in Boston, a National Education Convention. And I was sitting next to a priest who, strangely enough, was from the Diocese of Wichita. And we were having lunch. And I turned to him. I said, so I hear Wichita really has got stewardship by the tail and knows what it's all about. And Father McGreed basically invented it. I said, tell me about it. He goes, I'll do you one better. Why don't you fly out, bring some friends, and stay with me at my parish? I said, you got a deal. And we did. A whole bunch of us went out there. And we had a wonderful time. And we understood what that diocese in particular really spawned and gave birth to. And I brought it back. And so many of you remember those days. We embraced it. And it has, in my opinion, landed us where we are today, which is in a very good place. And I brought some of those folks out here to talk to us, their director, their superintendent, and a few others, so that we could have this kind of joining together from one parish to another, one diocese to another. And we learned a lot, and we've continued to do that. And it shows in so many ways. As I said to you last week, we have wonderful sacramental functions in our church, more than most. I got my cheat sheet here. 45 baptisms, 70 funerals, 15 weddings. There are Catholic churches not far from here who have 5 baptisms. So there are forces at work that we have to understand, because we're strong. And if what Christ said to Peter applies to you and I, then we do have work to do. I finished the book and I want to share with you a couple little other odds and ends before I start to talk about what kinds of things we're going to do. I won't read the part I read last week. This is the very first thing it says. In the United States, we are currently experiencing the largest and fastest religious shift in the history of the country. Tens of millions of formerly regular Christian worshipers nationwide have decided they no longer desire to attend church at all. These are what this book will call the de-churched. 40 million adults in America today used to go to church, but they do not anymore. They account for 16% of the adult population. For the first time in 8 decades, the Gallup organization, which tracks American religious membership, more adults in the United States do not attend church than attend church. This is not a shift. This is a jolt that we have to be aware of. No group of people are immune from the great de-churching. They are split evenly among men and women, 52%, 48% respectively. Roman Catholics, Protestants, and those who identify as other Christians have all de-churched at 32%. In the Protestant tradition, Presbyterians lead it, losing almost 50% of their entire congregation over the last 25 years. This is largely due to de-churching in mainline Presbyterian churches, Methodists, Baptists, Pentecostals, and Roman Catholics. By generation, how many of you are baby boomers? Here, raise your hands. Okay, this next part concerns us. We're the ones that have to get to work, because some of this is our fault. By generation, baby boomers, those born between 1946 and 64, are de-churching in the largest numbers, as more than 35% of boomers living today have stopped attending church. The situation is urgent. Not only is the scope of de-churching large, we need to engage them. In just a generation, the children of the de-churched will be unchurched, changing the nature of spirituality in this country significantly and probably forever. The Pine Tops Foundation projects, even in the most optimistic scenarios, Christian affiliation in the United States shrinks dramatically. And in the base case, 1 million youth, at least nominally in the church today, will choose to leave each year for the next 3 decades. 35 million youth raised in families today that call themselves Christian will say they are not by the year 2050. It is up to us to find a path forward in which we invite our brothers and sisters back. And that's one of the ways that they put up as a solution. Most people who have left said if someone would invite them back, they would at least consider coming, if not return completely. Just the invitation to come back. And that's where we all come in. And I've said this for many, many years. I think you are a crafty group of people. You have picnics and barbecues in your backyards. You know your neighbors. Many of them, probably 40 to 50% are Roman Catholic. You have to bring it up subtly, you know, and let them know how much fun you have coming here. At least I hope we do, not just in church, but in all the organizations that so many of you are part of here. Let them know, you know, well, I can't come on Sunday morning. Why? Because, oh, well, I have to attend church and maybe you want to try it yourself. Well, that's a little direct, but, you know, get the idea. But that's one of the most most important ways in all of their kind of analysis that people are waiting, simply to be asked, to be invited to please come back. And it's very, very easy to do. We in this church are going to begin by looking at ourselves, and there will be some concrete things that we're going to do very shortly. We will all take and fill out a new census card, which you may think is kind of simplistic, but we need to find out exactly who we are. We have census cards in volumes over in the building, and some of them are 20 years old. Some of them are census cards for people who are now with God in heaven. Some of them have moved, and some are just disconnected completely. We need a new one, and we'll be putting that in the pews in a couple weeks. We're also going to do a survey, and we did one probably 8 years ago, but we're going to do a new one for you to contribute your thoughts about our future, about the present, about what we need to be doing for that future moment. We have so many ministries and so many we plan on launching in the next few months. We'll have roundtable discussions. We'll be inviting you to come to the auditorium and talk around the table and offer the comments and ideas. We have to plan. You know, a lot of my brothers, God love them all, and, you know, I really wish I could teach in the seminary, or maybe they wouldn't want me, but I'd shake things up, to say the least. But so many of my dear brothers think that all they have to do when they're named a pastor is just stand behind the altar and dress like this and open the door and they'll show up. It doesn't work that way anymore. It's kind of like, if you say Mass, they will come. There has to be a lot more going on. You have to have wonderful music that's contemporary. You have to have all kinds of people involved, and we do have all of that, but we have to do even more. We have over 1,000 people that are watching us right now. That's why I shaved this morning. We have over 1,000 people everywhere in the United States and far away that tune in because they think that we are that place where they want to be on a Sunday morning, and that's wonderful. I leave you with this. When we went out to Kansas, one of the things they stressed were what were called the four pillars of stewardship. And when we went to the seminar and they began enunciating them and defining what they really meant, I was surprised at the order in which they were given. They were hospitality, prayer, formation, and service. Hospitality. Jesus fed 5,000 people and told the disciples, I'm not going to send them away hungry. He was on the sea, on the shore of the Sea of Galilee, making breakfast for them after the resurrection. And he said, come and eat. And there are other examples like that. And not just food, but the way in which people greet each other on Sunday morning and talk to each other and know what's going on in people's lives and understand when somebody is sick or somebody is having a health issue or whatever the case may be and comes over and hugs them and tells them, what can I do? Hospitality takes many, many forms. Our parish center is one of the most open places in the whole world. We have so many people that come and they want to sit down and they want to talk to Diane for 2 and 3 hours at a time. And I have to rescue her sometimes. It's a beautiful thing. They find a seat and they start to talk about their life, their work, the whole thing. And then I pick up, Diane, we have a meeting in about 5 minutes. Could you come see me, please? It's a beautiful thing. That's hospitality. Prayer. Prayer is how we gather here, but it's also the cornerstone ministry. It's the Bible study. It's our kids going to religious ed masses. It's so many different things. And it's your private prayers at home, in the car, wherever you are. Prayer, something we all have in common, including many who are not coming to church necessarily. But prayer, so very, very important. Formation. We have over 300 kids in our religious ed program, and I credit Debbie Derricks and Jean Cawhey for that. They run an incredible program. And I can tell you that sometimes we take in some people from other places where things are, well, didn't quite go well, and they come here because they heard we kind of take everybody, and we do. And that's for a parish our size. Imagine 5 parishes in town, 5. With about 4 more, still 15 minutes away, and we get 300 kids. That's fantastic. And finally, service. We have a list of social justice ministries that numbers well over 20. Service for us is the community. It's Wayne with the food network. It's Patterson at Eva's and Father English. It's Ecuador with a fishing village. It's making meals for people here who happen to have a loss in their family at a really terrible time. It's so many different ways. Hospitality, prayer, formation, and service. And maybe we haven't emphasized them enough. Maybe they're kind of on a low flame right now, but we have to ratchet those up again. We've done it in the past. It exists right now. But we have to intensify the burning flame that those 4 things are. And I know that we will be able to do that. So the next few weeks and months are going to be a time of change and a time of introspection for all of us. We cannot let what this book says happen here. We have to somehow be that bright shining light. And they give plenty of examples of places and groups that have done it and continue to do it. And we will look at those examples. We will go down that path and we will grow and we will embrace others and we will be here 100 years from now, whatever it takes, because we are the people of God, like Peter, upon whom the church rests. Please rise. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the 3rd day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. We place our prayers and petitions before Almighty God, and the response will be, hear us.
That those who know the gift of friendship and marriage remain constant in love through every trial, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
That those separated by death from those they love take comfort in the promise of the resurrection, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For those who generously share their time, talent, and treasure, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For those homebound, for those in rehabilitation, and for those in hospice care, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For those who are in need of our prayers and all those who have asked us to pray for them and for all whose names appear on the sick list in our parish bulletin, may God fill their lives with healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear us.
For all who have died to rise with Christ in eternal light, especially Ferdinand Dimitui, Michael Patrico, Michael Konechny, Leon Paconis, Ted Hoff, Pat Gern, for whom this Mass is offered, Lord, in your mercy,
hear us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, and blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Our Lady of Consolation,
pray for us.
And now, my friends, as we have shared the Word of God together, I invite you to spend time with me in front of the Blessed Sacrament as we share our spiritual prayer of communion. Friends, we now invite you to spend some time in adoration before the Blessed Sacrament in the tabernacle. We usually follow up my reflections and my gospel reflections with this time. And so often I will say to you, pray and reflect on a psalm or on some of the words of the gospel, something Jesus says or a parable. This is a great time to do that. And so join me now as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And my friends, as you spend time before the Lord, may he bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Enjoy these moments of private prayer and reflection.
St. Jude is the patron saint of hopeless causes and desperate situations. Catholics have relied on his intercession in times of extreme need for centuries. This apostle and martyr has helped countless souls through his epistle in the New Testament and his intercessions on behalf of those who seek his aid in times of trial. Pray this St. Jude Novena for your intentions, asking St. Jude to intercede to God the Father, his Son Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit on your behalf. We like to say that he is the patron saint of impossible causes, because even though something may seem hopeless, with God there is always hope.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Most holy Saint Jude, apostle, martyr, and friend of Jesus, today I ask that you pray for me and my intentions. You are the patron of the impossible. Pray for me and my intentions. O St. Jude, pray that God's grace and mercy will cover my intentions. Pray for the impossible if it is God's will. Pray that I may have the grace to accept God's holy will, even if it is painful and difficult for me. St. Jude, you loved our Lord. Help me to love him more. O St. Jude, pray for me that I may grow in faith, hope, and love, and in the grace of Jesus Christ. Pray for these intentions, but most of all, pray that I may join you in heaven with God for all eternity. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The first glorious mystery is the resurrection. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, Pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The second glorious mystery, the Ascension. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, Pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, our hope. To thee do we pray, poor vanished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, the Holy Mother of God, that we may be worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, while meditating upon the mysteries of the most holy rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And now, my friends, as we have shared the Word of God together, I invite you to spend time with me in front of the Blessed Sacrament as we share our spiritual prayer of communion. Friends, we now invite you to spend some time in adoration before the Blessed Sacrament in the tabernacle. We usually follow up my reflections and my gospel reflections with this time. And so often I will say to you, pray and reflect on a psalm or on some of the words of the gospel, something Jesus says, or a parable. This is a great time to do that. And so join me now as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And my friends, as you spend time before the Lord, may he bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Enjoy these moments of private prayer and reflection.